8,850 pounds as we see it here today. This is something a little different. This is an Eagle HT 280 RSOK here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. And this is a flat deck fifth wheel. Now, normally I use that designation for these big giant triple slides, but it is 100% accurate in the case of this Eagle HT. This is the travel trailer version of a 28.5 RSTS Eagle HT. All they did was just smash it down, take the fifth wheel out of the fifth wheel. And the way they did it is really intelligent. So you're thinking, like, why would you do that? Well, the trick with a lot of, quote, half-ton fifth wheels is that they're not generally half-ton towable because they weigh too much on the hitch, and the payload rating of most half-tons can't handle them. And that is where this beauty comes in. If you want a fifth wheel, you have a half-ton, but you found out you couldn't tow that fifth wheel, this is your get out of jail free pass, where you are going to sacrifice nothing in the way of features, amenities, feel, luxury. It's awesome. Like its fifth wheel cousin, the 28.5 RSTS Eagle HT, with these slides closed, it does prevent us from getting to the refrigerator. But if you want to make a little sleepover stop, you want to get to the bathroom or the bedroom on a long trip, this is going to be mostly a destination trailer, and it serves that purpose very well. Now, when you reach your destination, this thing opens right up and it feels massive inside. And again, that concept, the recurring theme here is going to be calling this thing a flat deck fifth wheel and explaining why. Well, it starts with the fact that this is 6 inches taller than a conventional travel trailer. Eagle HT trailers have a whopping 7 foot floor to ceiling interior clearance. And that gives you the ability to have these extra tall slides, to have that big open feeling, taller storage, bigger shower. This also has larger beds that we'll see up in the bedroom available to you as well. Just like its fifth wheel Eagle HT counterpart, we've got a whisper ducted air system, and that's a standard 15,000 BTU air. You don't have to upgrade the air system on an Eagle HT. It already comes equipped the way it needs to. And if you don't see the square, then you won't hear the air. It will be dramatically quieter. As long as we're talking about the AC system, it's not going to hurt to take a look at the fact that we have both vented and louvered ducts. And that's all fancy talk for the fact that it can turn and close every single duct in here to give you maximum control over your airflow system. Which is another thing Jayco's actually become very good at, is that their air systems are more efficient, both the heating and the cooling systems. And let's go ahead and get this out of the way. A common question I get is, why are they still putting heat vents in the floor? And the answer is because this is a truly tested, proven 0 to 100 degree RV. You lose 37% of your heat efficiency when you go to cabinet ducting. Every single time there's a 90 degree bend, it's the equivalent of 20 feet of straight ducting in terms of airflow loss and turbulence. And to get one cabinet duct, you need 3 of those 90-degree bends. You do the math. And that's why this thing heats vastly more efficiently. When it is cold camp season, your furnace might get to take a break here. You don't want to go burning that candle at both ends. Now, the non-floor ducted heat systems, they'll hold up during your warranty period, but probably not much longer if you're going to be using them cold camping and just running them ragged the entire time. So we'll come back to our dining arrangement over here, but that taller slide allowing for those bigger windows. But note the clutch detail here. Eagle's still giving you storage above your sofa seating, and that seems to be a dying breed. They are one of the last holdouts doing that because every ounce of storage counts, and they don't let an ounce of space go to waste. Now, I've got some brutal morning light coming in through these windows. I've got a couple of those blackout shades pulled, but with the backlight on them, you can see that every window here opens for airflow, including the sofa and theater seat side windows. So you get awesome light, awesome views, awesome airflow everywhere. And this over here, this is great. You don't usually see travel trailers. This is a power theater recliner, which is one of the few updates on this compared to a previous generation. And typical Eagle fashion, they always take it up a notch. Their power theater recliner also has USB outlets on either side to keep your phones up and running and charged up. And it's those kinds of extra details that separate them here. Like if you look at both of these sofa side stands, you see those little green dots staring at us? Those are double sets of USB plugs with a double set of household outlets below them. So I don't care where you're sitting. I don't care how many devices you have. This Eagle has like, I don't know, over 10 USB plugs in it all over the place to keep your devices up and running, charged up. And what's also kind of cool is those household outlets on both sides of that sofa back there make this guest CPAP friendly. And that's another very cool quality about Eagle travel trailers and fifth wheels. They are good for not just grandkids. You could definitely stack a couple grandkids on there, but you could also very comfortably sleep two adults on there. I know, because I've spent more than one weekend on a rear guest hide bed like that with my wife sleeping next to me and my daughter in the theater seat beside me. So this is easily two guest friendly, but also very potentially three guest friendly if one of them is small, because that theater seat nearest to us can still fully recline. Now you might notice it's a little dimmer in here. That's because this has dimmer switch lighting, appropriately enough. I wonder if that's why the one's called the other. But anyway, you see that I've pulled all the blackout shades. Eagles allow us to do one of the best versions of what I call stealth mode camping with this dimmer switch lighting right here. And look at the ridiculous difference that makes when you see it in an AB comparison. Now, you might notice it also has positional memory. So it will remember if you have the lights turned up or down when you dim or ignite those switches. And it's that extra kind of little detail stuff that goes into Eagles that not every brand has. There's just no other brand that goes quite as hard, quite as far, as consistently as Eagle RVs. But that's also why they're not the least expensive and the lightest weight RV out there. They've got more guts to them and they carry a little more heft. Now take note of that TV. You see how that pivots around? So I don't care, you can make it face that rear sofa. You can use the sofa and the theater seat as like a little conversation corner. You can make it pivot around here over to the couples or guest-friendly dining arrangement that we'll look at in just a minute. And little accents, like you see the accent lighting behind that Silver Eagle frame there within the slide between the windows. Just nice little touches. It's little things like this that I call that no neck wrecker entertainment system that just take these Eagles once again over the top. Now, down below that, naturally, we have an electric space heating fireplace, which is an electric heater that we call a fireplace. It's remote controlled, by the way. And if you want to use it for just cool LED visuals without burning up your propane and introducing extra heat, like you can make it look cool during the summertime and not be hot. Now, over here, within the slide, you can see that it's a pretty conventional kitchen slide. We've got all of our big appliances in that slide off the floor plan. But that is really just kind of a tip of the iceberg. I want to give you a good look at everything before I just start blowing this sucker open and introducing you to a ton of storage. The storage in this Eagle, you could say, is kitchen-credible. Now, under the fireplace is obviously just a little tiny pocket. But even down there, they're still using hidden hinge cabinets. I mean, they're very consistent and clean in their execution. That might be good for a couple slippers or something. I don't know. Now, above the entertainment center, because behind the TV there's not storage because there's an outside camp kitchen that we'll see outdoors, but up here you see a big, deep pocket. And you're thinking, well, what am I going to do with that? Well, this is where if you wanted to expand your entertainment center, you could. And that's why there's just a ton of household outlets up in this thing, which you can't see very well. Hold on just a second. There's some light for you. There you go. We're doing it on the fly. We're doing it live, people. Except not live. Anyway, over here also, they're running all HDMI wiring in these, and they even give you an extra one. Now, the reason that's really cool is this is all high-def capable, but without high-def wiring, it's not going to do you any good. And Jayco's been doing high-def wiring for 2 years more than just about anybody else. So if you want to add a Blu-ray or something like that, you've got the ability to actually get high-def output. And by running that extra HDMI cable, they save you the hassle of trying to like dismount and tear apart your entertainment center to run it yourself. They've done the hard work for you. Now back here to the kitchen prime. I love that. Really cool looking microwave. Now that is a combination microwave and vent hood, by the way. I've had some folks not realize that and say, oh my God, they quit venting their kitchens. No, they still vent their kitchens. Now around the corner here, you're going to see a couple of these. You'll see one in the outside kitchen. It's intended to be a mount for, and my personal opinion, is an overpriced portable Bluetooth speaker. But you know what else it still is? It's still a dual USB hub. So no matter what, if you choose to buy that for like 90 bucks or 100 bucks or whatever, Furion Bluetooth speaker that hooks onto that, which is neat, but if you choose to do, or if you don't choose to do that, you still get a place to keep your phones and stuff charged up. Now, the stainless appliance bundle is absolutely on point here in this lighter farmhouse decor. And if you're not like, ooh, I don't know about all this white colored wood and the darker, you know, very dark. This isn't black, by the way. If I get right up close here, you can see it's actually like an espresso brown. It's a very dark brown. If you're not into all that, they still make one with brown, and browner decor called American Tradition. So don't worry, guys. Everything else stays the same, just the wood tones change. But over here, the kitchen storage just don't quit in this Eagle. It is maybe too legit to quit. Now, a neat little thing here. I was a little surprised. They've got a heavy-duty magnet latch holding this door shut, and I think that's actually really smart and really important, because if this door pops open in transit, it will pop open behind that slide-out flange, and it's going to be very easy to break. And they've eliminated that potential, basically, here. Now, up top, you see that little kind of corner chunk taken out of the cabinet? That is your master control center. We'll see that in just a second. But down below here, I love convertible storage. This is either a big old closet, as you see it right here, or you can very easily flip the switch, flip the script. You could roll it over, flip it, and reverse it, and convert it into a extra pantry space. And when is extra storage ever the wrong answer? So whether you want coats, if you don't want coats, you want jackets, you want none of that, you want just all the potential space you could possibly get, you get anything and everything you want here. And we are still not done with the storage, because we still got to look at our island. You see, we've got a high-rise sprayer faucet. I pulled the faucet end down a little bit so you can see that. But do a little bit of the wedding ring test, and then in Jayco, you hear the sound of metal clinking off that wedding ring instead of plastic, because you can get something that looks exactly like that, but it's plastic, it's cheaper, and it's probably not going to hold up as well. And that's, again, why this is not the least expensive or lightest weight trailer out there. That is one example of a lot of examples of what goes into an Eagle. All of our countertops are sealed edge thermal foil, but not just the kitchen. Remember those sofa side stands? And up in the bedroom, the side stands are also made with the same material. So if you splash some water around, or if a drink sweats a little bit, well, you don't have to sweat, basically. And I love the asymmetrical island, because it means that with the sink shoved over to one side, you've always got prep space, even if the sink is in use. And that creates all kinds of drawer space over here. So you've got plywood drawers to the floor of this thing. And I love how they split the area under the sink. They're giving you both an area for your, you know, dish soaps, as well as a large wastebasket below that stainless steel sink. And that's a bamboo chef-grade cutting board, by the way. Over here in our dining arrangement, first of all, I want to point out the fact that all of our windows open for airflow. I mentioned that, but it's good to see the slide side airflow windows. I didn't want to just talk about it. You see that this is a very couples-oriented dinette, and this is another thing that costs a couple bucks more in Eagles. They do two different types of chairs. But most of the time, I bet 99% of the time, there's only going to be two of you in here. So you want that extra elbow room. But what if you have a guest? Well, that's when you get a little bit creative, and they give you all the tools to do so. This is what I call a destination dining desk, because it starts with the fact that the tabletop flips up with that gas strut to give you easy access to the storage pocket below. We have a countertop extension leaf and a pair of hideaway guest chairs that you can easily store below the queen or king bed, depending on how you want yours built. And you have the ability to very comfortably sit four adults, but most of the time, again, it's probably just going to be the two of you. Now, moving up here, there's another really neat thing. They're giving you the best of new and old. Like, you've got this handheld little remote control, and these have been in the industry for years now. Usually it's 4 zeros, then check, thank you. So if you want to be able to control your awning lights, your slides, you know, all kinds of different stuff, you've got a nice little touchscreen wireless remote control here. And where that's really neat is it allows you to be outside while your awning's opening, so you can direct line of sight that, or you can open and close your slides. Like, if you think maybe you're a little too close to something over there, you can take that remote control and open the slide from outside and visibly watch your slide open to make sure it's not going to connect to anything. But there's a lot of people who are like, I ain't up for all this newfangled technological stuff. And so they still include a physical switch panel here. Now, this is also where you'd activate your water pump and your water heater, both gas and electric sides, and your tank monitor. And then just little things like this. Eagle includes a handy little tire pressure monitor, or, you know, tester, basically, so that you have a handy tire pressure thing there for your pre-trip. Now, this box right here says wired for solar. We'll talk more about that on the roof, but basically these Eagles are both roof and side mount solar ready. Now, in here in the bathroom, yet again, more features you just don't find elsewhere, and I never remember which switch does what. So first of all, there we go. Above our shower, we've got a single blue LED light, and that's going to act like a nightlight. And even during the day, it kind of makes that whole shower glow, and it'll give you sort of like a roadmap as to where you need to go. Now remember, with this RV being 7 foot tall, you will not have trouble in this 30 by 36 inch shower, especially with that radius beam on top. Now, of course, we have good main cabin lighting. And that would be great if they did just that and stopped, it'd be fine. But behind the mirror, they also have a backlit morning light. So that if you do want to, like, you know, get ready in the morning without blinding yourself, you can. So again, we have a large, easy step-in shower. And like I said, with this being 7 foot tall, I mean, I'm on my toes and I still can't. Even if I do an ET neck stretch and phone home, I can't clip this with my forehead. And with that radius bar, lots of elbow room in here. Now we have a porcelain foot flush stool that, walking out of that shower backwards, I almost tripped down and killed myself, which would have been hilarious, of course. More sealed edge countertop, and a huge chunk of it with that nice tile backsplash. That's not a small sink, it's just a really big counter. But you see this big blocky thing over here. What is that? Well, shared between the bedroom and bathroom is a huge bonus closet. And that's where this is a little different from the fifth wheel, to help keep that hitch weight in check compared to the fifth wheel. Because remember I said that this is ideal for like a big heavy half ton that can't handle a fifth wheel, and the camera's got ADD and lost a little focus there. But the fact is, you've got extra storage here. So if you want extra towel space and whatnot, you can use that. But that's also accessible here in the bedroom. This is the opposite side of that exact same cabinet. Now the top portion is segmented only for bedroom access. What you saw accessible from the bathroom is this down here. So it's just a huge amount of extra storage space. You can convert that into extra closet space or whatever you want. Instead of a fifth wheel closet slide, you're getting this 7 foot tall standing closet. But you might notice how those doors right there are slotted. That is for airflow, because if you look a little bit closer in there, you see that this is also prepped and ready for a combination washer dryer. So this is a late model, potentially half ton towable, albeit it's still a very heavy half ton tow. I've completely acknowledged that, but you're getting fifth wheel features. Some of this, like this washer dryer prep, is not available in an Eagle HT fifth wheel 28.5 RSTS. So in some ways, it's actually got extra advantages that a fifth wheel version of this floor plan does not have. Now, 7 foot tall, that means they can give you a deep overhead cabinet without it being a head knocker. This is second air ready. That's what that little junction box is there. And you see the TV hookups that can, so you can mount a TV on the wall opposed to the bathroom, basically. But that's not what I want to focus on in here. That's all neat stuff. It's the really cool personalized individual controls that you get on everything here. So these inward angled closets are neat. But if you notice right down at the base there, on both sides, you have your own easy reach switches. So one of those is for like a little, side stand light, and one is for our overhead light. And you see how they operate individually. And then you can also reach those individually. So this thing gives you all kinds of individualized light control. Now right here, this is something that was actually literally for a time called the Haylett RV King Bed, available in Eagle HTs here at Haylett RV. We were a dealer who custom requested this initially when previously king beds were not available in Eagle HT. So we said, throw us a king bed in there because I think it'll work very well with your really big, tall feel. I think there's a lot of people who want fifth wheel feels in a travel trailer. And they said, okay, we'll do that. Well, all of a sudden, Jayco started getting orders submitted from other dealers requesting the Haylett King Bed. So there was a period. This was literally named after us at Haylett RV. And of course, storage below the bed. You can see how it's easy lift, plywood deck base, and that's a normal recurring trend with Jayco. You just don't see OSB in their production, really. That's one of the reasons they have the industry's best warranty, and we'll talk a little bit more about that in just a second. But down here, this is that chest storage, and again, that is one of those two full-away guest chairs, and it comes in a handy little traveling sleeve so that if you do stack them up or you put other cargo on them or under them or whatever, they're not going to chatter against one another and get all dinged up and scarred up. And something I should have spoken on much, much sooner than this is the fact that there is no manufacturer out there in the main market with a better warranty than Jayco. And really, there hasn't been. Whether it's this Eagle or those J Flights over there, those real basic J Flight SLXs, Jayco's always had twice the warranty of pretty much everybody else. They've got a 2-year RV warranty. Now, what screwed everybody up is all of a sudden Brand X out there starts saying, no, we have a 3-year warranty on the structural stuff. But they never really went out of their way to explain what that includes. Now, a couple brands like Keystone have really done a good job of explaining what 3-year structural means to them, but it's not the same for every brand. Now, those 3-year structural brands still only have a 1-year RV warranty, and good gravy. I love those. I call them lightsaber glow beams right along the nose of that thing. Well, back to the warranty topic. Jayco said, you know what? We're going to just take all the mystification out of this thing, and we are going to provide a 2+3 warranty. Everybody else is a 1+3. We're going to do a 2+3. So there is, categorically, no main market manufacturer who has a better warranty than Jayco. Now, up front here, this is something special. These Eagle HTs have a very unique quality, this front cargo utility tray. You can see my little red battery box powering us up out here, powered up those cool orange glow beams that we saw. This thing is great. If you want to load this thing with batteries for off-grid camping, like if you're going to go solar nuts, because this has side and roof solar prep, mind you, if you want a small generator, or pretty much anything you can imagine, you want to put just a big tote with some tools or some hitching stuff or whatever up there, it's a cool blank canvas area where you can do a lot of good things. Now, we'll come back and look at the pass-through storage, but while we're over here, one of the things I wanted to zero in on is this very fifth wheel style docking station, because once again, what is this thing? It's a flat deck fifth wheel. Out here, we have our side solar prep, outside utility shower, and all of these levers and everything are very clearly listed, so it's very easy to understand what each of these do. All of our gate valves, everything is heated, enclosed, protected. This is insulated just like one of their fifth wheels, 0 to 100 degree protected, proven cold chambered tested data behind these Jaycos. They don't just make claims, they verify them first, and that's unfortunately a shockingly rare quality among manufacturers out there. Now you can see the main chassis here, but as I turn left you see the I-beams that drop down. Like I said, just like a big fifth wheel, this has a drop frame to get you to that extra large front storage compartment. Below our slide here, I want to point out a couple things. If you look at that widget that is linking the suspension together, that is a Mooride CRE 3000 system. That stands for Compression Rubber Equalization. What that means in English is shock dampener. This is a smoother riding trailer. Also, you see these big giant tires. First of all, right out of the gate, they're best in class. They're Goodyear Endurance radials rated to travel at up to 87 miles per hour at only 80 PSI. And if you don't know what that means, it means that if you want to stop at any gas station and put air in your tires with a little, you know, gas station air pump, you can. You do not need to go to an industrial tire shop. Another thing there, you might have noticed those tires were large. We outfit these Eagle HTs with the same 16-inch radial tires that you will find on something like a big 35, 37-foot Eagle fifth wheel that weighs more than this thing, that weighs 5,000 pounds more than this thing. If you are looking for that ultimate in reliability, a bigger tire will generate less heat because it circles fewer times per hour, basically, and it will be more reliable. All sorts of windows here, every one of which opens for airflow, but that's not what I want to focus on back here. Like, this has a 2-inch receiver hitch on the back for accessories, and that's also very cool. But what I want to talk about back here is an industry-exclusive feature, and that is the J-Smart lighting system. That stands for Signals, Markers, and Reverse Travel. So you might notice there's all kinds of upper clearance lights on here, and there's that white bar just above the rear view camera prep. And then in the taillights themselves, there's also these white elements. So when you flip on your turn signal in most RVs, only the left or right brake light is actually going to flash to indicate your intentions on the road, but not in an Eagle. In an Eagle, those taillights blink, the upper clearance lights blink, and all associated side marker lights blink, just like a semi-trailer. So if you're trying to merge into the right lane and you have your signals on over here, somebody on this side is going to see your intentions. They're going to try to get out of the way because they don't want you to clobber them. Or if you're backing up at night, you have 3 sets of reverse lights to light up the area behind you so that whether it's your mirrors, a rear view camera, or a spotter, anybody, everybody can see what you're doing. Or frankly, during the day, People who aren't familiar with RVs are still familiar with reverse lights. So if you're at a funky gas station area and you have to kind of weave your way out of there and back your way out of something, people behind you are going to know what you're doing, even if you can't see them. They're more apt to get out of the way. It is just better, safer, and it's just one of those things that Jayco does that, frankly, nobody else does. I also wanted to take a minute to open up that awning, because whenever there's a slide under an awning, everybody has a little bit of a heart attack. So instead of tell you it's okay, I thought I'd show you it's okay. This is a deep awning. That's a shallow slide. Kitchen slides have been under awnings for multiple years now, and they work just fine. They really just don't eat up enough space. Plus, they put a long awning. It goes way up to that bedroom window. There's plenty of room out here for your picnic tables and chairs. Now, in addition to that outside kitchen, this still has a second outside gas grill quick connect over here, just under the end of that bumper. So if you want to have a bumper grill or griddle in conjunction with the camp kitchenette that's mounted within the slide itself over here with that awesome smoking hot Capital grill, you're good to go. Now on the end, you can see that we've got the Jayco emblazoned. You got the Bluebird on there, barley poppinator, which is good obviously for opening bottles of water if it has hops and barley in it. And out here in this camp kitchenette, you see we've got the all galvanized rolled steel countertops. One of the reasons that Jayco has flipped over to this is this grill burns so hot that if it was really hot and you put it away, they never had a single instance, I'd never heard of any manufacturer had an instance where this grill was catching a conventional countertop on fire, but there were instances where they pulled it out and it was a little bit toasted, basically. So they said, nope, no sweat, we're going to make sure that's never going to be an issue in here. Now you notice down inside here there's USB plugs, there's household outlets, but you see more household outlets up here behind this storage area. If you want to, you could very easily mount a TV up here, and actually Jayco has a factory option for a camp kitchen TV, kind of turn that into like an enclosed cabinet, and yeah, obviously you've got the TV hookups and the power outlets to power all that. Now, one of the cool things here is that outside kitchen door is very large, very tall, so it acts like a good sort of weather shield, but again, it's all the way under the awning, which is another thing people ask for. It's funny how sometimes people don't want awnings over slides, but they always want awnings over outside kitchens. Well, they've provided that here, you know, there's a lot of good things going on. Speaking of good things going on, we have an anti-slam entry door with a full viewing window, not a frosty glass, and privacy shade within that window. And you can see how stable step system Eagle uses is the zero G system. It holds itself. It's got a strut basically, so it won't fall down, crush your feet, crush your dog, crush your kids, whatever. And over here, you can see that they're also including not just a folding entry handle, but like a Jayco Pinnacle Luxury XL sized folding handle, so that you have something to hold on to the entire way up and down the stairs. That is good whether you are young or old or even in between. I don't care. It's always nice to have something to hold on to. Then there's smart little things like your step lighting. Eagle puts a switch outside of the RV for your step lighting, which is under here. During the day, it doesn't provide us a whole lot to look at night, though. It's very, very beneficial. Also smart things like installing their speakers in the skirt as opposed to within the sidewall itself. Takes 2 4-inch holes out of the sidewall, which are potential bend points, leak points, etc. And they put them down where you can actually hear them instead of, pardon me, all the way up where you've got to blow away the neighbors. Now, one of the other neat things that's fairly unique within the Jayco family is the fact that this has a very fifth wheel style drop frame storage compartment. So once again, this offers fifth wheel features in a travel trailer scenario. You can see that aluminum skeleton work running through there. This is built part for part just like their bigger fifth wheels. Motion sense lighting, household outlets, and some handy battery disconnect, easy to reach right here, so that your water heater and all your circuit panels and stuff, they're not going to trickle draw off that battery, so your power tongue jack is going to be there ready and waiting for you. And when you look down here, you see the same industrial rubberized floor here that you'd find in a Jayco toy hauler. So they're giving you some real heavy-duty components as a way of making sure that, like, you know, cargo doesn't shift around. And even if, like, I know a lot of people, when you get there, you want to set up, you're tired, you grab your weight distribution bars and you just chuck them into that middle area. Well, that stuff's pretty rugged. You can slide hitches around in there and you're not going to tear up your flooring.
Man, that
is a good looking roof. That is how a roof is supposed to look right there. It starts with the same roof membrane that 99% of the RV industry uses, and it comes in under 100 different names. But have you ever noticed how these RV roof membranes all seem to have just about the same warranty? It's because they're made by just about the exact same facility with the exact same compounds. The people who supply these RV roofs, I tell you, they're like Taco Bell. You know how every time you go to Taco Bell, whatever you order, it's meat, cheese, and vegetables in a tortilla? Well, whoever supplies the RV industry with 99% of these roof skins, all they do is they'll take their molecular compound, they'll change it by like one molecule, and give it a new name and call a brand exclusive with it. And I tell you, I wish I were that smart. I'm not even criticizing. I'm just jealous. So down below the skin, that's what matters. Now, you see, all these RVs, it's not the roof skin. Like when people say, oh, it has a 12-year, 15-year, 18-year roof warranty. That's just the skin. And they all have pretty much the same skin. So what's under the skin? Well, with a Jayco, directly below the skin, you actually find adhesive. And I don't talk about that enough. There are a lot of brands out there that do not glue down their roof membrane. And if you start looking around in the Facebook groups, you find a lot of pictures of these things, like from a brand, they'll just say like Big Idea, whose roof membrane has ripped and ripped back like a sail because there's nothing holding it down. And it's one of those things that the customer can't see. But Jayco does the things the customer can't see, like glue down their roof skin. And they're doing it to plywood decking, not OSB decking. There's nobody else really in this class that's doing what Jayco's doing up here on the roof. Then it has thicker roof trusses, just like, say, a Big Eagle fifth wheel. And that gives them the heaviest load rating within this class and category. Now, you can also see they're very heavy-handed with their sealants. And just like bigger fifth wheels from the Eagle facility, you can see these are prepped not just for a side solar, but a roof solar application. Not a big trailer like this, there is plenty of real estate to be able to do all that. Now, they also do a very different bathroom vent fan here. The what's kind of becoming the more commercial name for it is a Vortex style, but what this is your air intake underneath here, and inside you can open and close those vents with these little fins. So what that means is that this basically is kind of like a max air vent fan, in which you can leave that fan running or leave those vents open even in the rain, and you're not going to get water pouring back into your RV. And then little things like, you see that funky little inverted mushroom cap right there? That is a different style of black tank cap, and what that effectively does is it pulls more air out of that black tank to give you better airflow so that you're not getting the backflow of odors through your RV. And it's extra little things like that that go into these Jaycos up here. And the fact that we quality control even the roofs of these RVs before we let the RV delivery driver unhook from it. And the fact that we even show you the roof of an RV when I don't know that there's really many others that even do that. It's those extra things that we do here for a Haylett RV. You know, there's a lot of reasons to purchase an Eagle, but there's a lot of Eagle dealers. So why would you pick us? You know, there's lots of dealers. They have good prices. But we just do a little bit more for you. We've gone a little bit further. We're willing to demonstrate that even before you pick up the phone, even before we meet you. Imagine what we do if you give us a chance to earn your business. And it does not matter where you live. These things are on wheels. We can get them from here to there. All you have to do is give us the opportunity. So take care, stay safe, have fun. Happy camping, everyone. And remember that we don't do hidden dealer fees, but we do everything else like hitching, pieces, parts, trades, finance, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything in between.